In this video, we will discuss the representation of different relations or table and database. So we are having the two main methods to express the relational schema. First one, we are having the short text statement, and second one, we are having the graphical methods. First one, when we say that short text statement, to represent the short text statement method, we have to write the relation name followed by the list of attributes enclosed in a parenthesis separated by comma. So here, if we check, customer is a relation, customer ID is a primary key, that is underlined, customer name, address, city, then state and postal code. These are the attributes of the customer table. Second one, order. Order ID is primary key, order date and customer ID is used as a foreign key. Whenever we are having the foreign key, always we have to use the dotted underline, your dash, dotted dash underlines will be used for the foreign key. That is the method for the short text statement, in which the name of the relationship followed by set of attribute enclosed in a parenthesis. It's very, the main benefit of this one is simplicity. It's very simple. But next one methods we are having, that is a graphical representation methods. The relation is represented by rectangle containing the attribute for relation. It provides the better means of expressing the referential integrity constraints to creating the relationship among the different relations. How we can represent it, how we can show it, let's see. Okay, we are having two different relation are here. First one is here, department. The name of relation is here, department. Attribute of this one relation are here, that we are using the different attribute, department ID, department name and department contact. Department ID, this one is a primary key, so we can use it over there, underline it, it's not directly, so we have to use this one. This one is a primary key. Next one, attribute, we see that department name, third one we have to use the department address. This one is related to the department table. Second one, we see that we are having another employee table. Here again we are having the different type of the attributes are there. List of attributes are here, employee ID, employee ID. Again this one is a primary key, so underline it. Next one attribute, we said it's a first name. or name. Next one, attribute is here, we see that is the date of birth. Birth date. And last one attribute we want to use it over here, department ID. This one department ID is used as a foreign key. So how we can use it? Dotted underline or dash underlines. Underline it but dash. Now we have to represent the relationship. Now this one is department ID is used as a foreign key, and the main parent table is for this one is department, and the department ID is a primary key in any other table. Attribute of one table that is used as a foreign key. So how we can represent it? We have to use the arrow symbol over here from the foreign key to make the parent table. Arrow symbol must be used over here. So in this way we may be able to represent the relation graphically. That is the way to represent the different relation graphically. It provides a better mean of expressing the referential integrity that represents the relationship among the different tables. Thanks for watching the video.